was a little bit of Walk on Water by 30 Seconds to Mars. Then added a little bit of, you know, new music to the list here. Yeah,
to the mix.
Yeah, to the mix. You know, I got the YouTube page on my phone, so as I'm listening to the radio going down the road and stuff like that, it just okay. That's a good song to put on. Let's add that. Let's add this. Let's add that. So, but anyway, so Chris, are you able to put out a little bit about that show you want to bring to DG in, or is that something you want to keep on the down low?
I was gonna talk to you a little bit more about it, but I can share a little bit about it. It's a show that's breaking reality. It's exactly what it says, what the title says. You know, the whole concept behind the show is, you know, I shared a little bit with you before. So the whole concept behind the show is to kind of prelude to a road show that I want to start doing.
Oh, yeah.
And that road show is going to travel all around the United States. And we're going to do the show live in front of an audience. And the concept comes from the, hey, we're not broken, so stop acting like you are.
That's right. He hit it on the nose. You know, there was a saying that I used to say all the time where everybody's broken in some kind of way, but that's the way God made us. And we should use our broken pieces to make us shine. But after I seen you make that quote, is, you know, we're not broken. We are the way that God made us. You know, God made us in his own image of the way we should be. I'm supposed to be 6'6", tall, goofy, one-legged, you know, big monster son of a bitch. But, you know, I still use that to grab people's attention. But we're not broken. But a lot of America and, you know, I'm not sorry if this offends anybody, because there's so many people out there that act like they can't do shit. You know, oh, well, I'm too tired. My knees hurt. How much do you weigh? The only reason why I say that is, God rest her soul, you know, my Aunt Charlene passed away a couple of days before Thanksgiving. And, you know, if you go to work, you come home, and you lay in bed or you lay on the couch, and all you do is eat, you're going to gain weight. You know, I was, before I went into the hospital in January 6, 2014, from losing my legs, I was 260 pounds solid. I could pick up an asset of a smart car. Within a year's time, that shit went away. And I was up to 360 pounds. I'm back down to 280. I got a doctor's appointment on the 5th. It's my random checkup. And he's the one that prescribes me my medicine. So I have my pain contract with him. So I also have to go in and take a drug test too. So, you know, Gotta go in and do my thing. Go pee the cup. But, you know, people's got to take the initiative to get up and do something with their life. You know, us being, you know, veterans and first responders, you know, whenever we leave our jobs, our sense of purpose kind of goes. And you got to find something. Chris, you got your thing going. We got DGN going. No, we got a sense of purpose in our life to keep going, to keep active, to keep going out and doing things and doing great things for other people. I don't know about y'all, but I love helping people out. Makes me smile. You know, mm-hmm. I was just going to say,
it takes a bit, though, for us to figure out what that purpose is. Like you said, you were at 260, then you went to 380. I took a similar route. When I got out, I was done. I didn't know what the hell I was going to do next. Next thing I know, I'm looking in the mirror. I remember seeing this photograph of me at a birthday party with my kids and my family and a bunch of friends. And I'm sitting there next to my mom, my brother, my sister, and my other sister. And here's this portly little 5'6" dude that was as big around as he was tall. Damn. And I'm like, who the hell is that guy? I didn't even recognize myself in this photo. And it was like, that was like the first kick in the face, you know, that kick in the teeth that you need say, you know what, there's way more to me than what I see in this photo. And, you know, now I'm like 212, you know, my shoulders are still as wide as I am tall, but hey, that goes from the work that you put in. And it was through that work that I found helping other people made me feel good, made me feel right.
There you go. And it does. It does take a little bit to find that purpose. And, you know, I'm grateful that you're bringing one of your shows to the network, Chris. I greatly appreciate it. It's an honor. And anybody else out there who wants to try to have their own radio show, you have all, by all means, we're not bound by FCC, so we can say whatever the fuck we want to. And, you know, you want to have your own show. You got something that you think you can bring to the table that can help others or just make people laugh or just have a badass time, email me at brian@dangerousgroundsnetwork.com or dgn1980@my.com. You can email one of those two email addresses and come on, you know. Make sure, please don't have an Apple computer, because setting up the tech that you need to run your show is absolutely almost near fucking impossible, because we haven't figured it out yet, and I've been doing this shit for a year now, so you know
it's not impossible. I'll just tell you that right now, it's not impossible. Hey, I got your back, man. If anybody's got an Apple computer, just send them over to me. I'll help them out.
Oh shit! Looks like I might be talking to you a little bit after. Man,
who's driving?
Nah, it's me. Sorry.
All right.
I might be talking to you afterwards, man, because that's something that I would like to know. I got a lot of it set up on here. I haven't found, you know, VB Audio and Voice Meter. I haven't been able to get to work on the Apple side of the house, so might have to talk to you about that.
Yeah. So we can have some others. Well, Voice Meter doesn't work.
Sometimes you got to be smarter than the machine, country.
Uh-huh. What'd you say, Chris?
I said, well, Voice Meter don't work on Apple products, so that's all good.
Yeah,
but they've got some other cool things that help out, and you know, it is what it is. You know, I've been doing this stuff since 2002, and 2003 when I took over for the state for the National Guard here in the state. And that, I tell you what, as technology grows, it gets harder and harder to keep up with it. But but really, it's not as difficult as what people want to make it out to be. If you really want a show, you should try it out. And best way to try it out is do like what I'm doing here. Just be a guest on somebody else's show. That's the best way to try out whether or not you want to be on the radio or not.
That's right. And that's something that we have in the intro. And we might leave out with the intro. I'm not sure yet. So that way people can hear it. But anybody can come on as a guest. You know, if you got something you want to say, you got something you want to talk about, you got something that you want to get off your chest, you got something you think that the general public needs to hear, because not only do we have the best country in the world listening to us, we got 13 other countries that listen to us on a regular basis. So, not only are you helping out your fellow Americans, you're helping out your fellow humans. You know, that's one thing that I took from Killer is, be a part of the American race. I mean, not American race, the human race. Because we all bleed red. We all put our clothes on the same damn way. We all have to go to work to provide for our families. And we all have to teach our kids how to live. And that's every human out there. You know? And, you know, I solely believe in that. You know? Be a part of the human race. Plain and simple. But, yeah, man, can't wait to get that show. Can't wait to get that show up on the air and going. And now that we got a couple of days, we'll be getting MMA and Jiu-Jitsu Corner up and going, and Southern Radio fixing to pop off here pretty soon with Chris Oliver, or Trigger Shot, as he likes to call himself, and his co. Actually, was it
Quick Shot is probably a better idea.
And congratulations to Big Chris, who got engaged over the holidays. Big shout out to you, Big Dog. You know, yes, do it. Please do it. You know. Not, the first one don't always work. The second one normally don't work. But the third one's always the fucking charm.
Third one's charm, huh? Is that what you're telling me?
Well, you know. Congratulations. Yeah,
I still got two more to go.
I'm on my third. So, I mean, this better be the damn charm. Because if not, I'm done.
I'm on my first one. And it's been going strong for 18 years. So, I better not screw this one up, because I don't think a second or third is gonna put up with my dumbass.
And congratulations to you, brother. And you know, there are a lot of first marriages out there who do strive and succeed in life. And you know, that's not saying it's true for everybody about the second and third marriages. I mean, sometimes people start too young. Sometimes people just rush into it. But then, you know, sometimes it
Amen.
Sometimes it takes a little bit for you to find your true soulmate. And when I say find your true soulmate, this is just my opinion. Somebody that's going to hold your hand and rub your neck or whatnot when you're going down the road. Somebody who don't mind just laying on the couch, curled up, watching TV, watching a movie, going off and doing something with the kids, a family life, and enjoy doing it. Don't be stuck up each other's ass 24/7, because then you lose things to talk about. You know, and that's something that's very important in a relationship is communication. And if you don't have nothing to talk about, what are you going to do besides sit there and twiddle your thumbs? I mean, that's just my opinion. But, yeah, other people may have other things at work. And if you do, please tip. What up, Ghost? I hear you riding down the road, man. What else is on the line?
I got home, and I think my furnace is messed up. It was 55 degrees in the house, and the heat wasn't on, so I turned it on, and it's still not warming up. It's actually gotten worse. So I think I'm going to have to call a repairman out here to the house and have him fucking check it out.
Uh-oh. Yeah. No bueno. If it wasn't for bad luck, you'd have no luck at all these last couple of days. I believe.
Yeah, no shit.
Man, when it comes, man. But, you know, family stands together. You still in Ohio, yep. Or you're on your way down south?
No. That's temporarily on hold. Once I get the official call, because he's still alive and he's doing the best he can, obviously, given the circumstances of what's going on with him and everything. But once I actually get the phone call from family, because some of the family staying overnight in the hospice room with him, they can only allow so many people in there. So it's kind of restricted. I'm restricted to close family, like his dad, his mom, and a couple of our cousins to stay overnight with him if they choose to. But during the day, we can all go up and, you know, visit with him and stuff like that. But I mean, he's still alive, but I mean, they've got him pretty much, medicated, just keeping him from being in pain and everything else. And once I get that call, then